Meet India's most wanted. 67-year-old Dr. Narendra Dabolkar, 81-year-old Govind Pansare, 76-year-old M.M. Kalburgi, and 55-year-old Gauri Lankesh. You aren't afraid of them, but obviously it scares somebody because one by one, they were eliminated. Dr. Narendra Dabolkar was on his usual morning walk in Pune on August 2013. CPI leader Govind Pansare too was just returning from his morning walk in Kolhapur in February 2015. Yaar, this morning walk seems to be very dangerous to your health. Dharwad, Karnataka-based M.M. Kalburgi, like the others, had been receiving death threats.
Remember Gandhi? Remember what we did to him?
He was shot dead in August 2015, only a few days after his security was removed. Gauri Lankesh, editor of Patrike, a left-leaning activist magazine fighting for social causes, she was just about to reach her home in Bangalore in September of 2017, as she unlocked her gate.
Her Majesty, now!
At the crime scene, send these empty casings to the forensic lab. These were fired from a 7.65mm country-made revolver.
Weren't 7.65s used in the killing of MMK also?
In fact, one of the pistols that was used to shoot MMK was used on Pansare, and another pistol used on Pansare was also the exact same one used on Dabolkar. While there were no cameras around where the others were killed, the cops managed to get CCTV footage of Gauri Lankesh's killing.
Rewind, stop, rewind there. Who is that fellow?
He turned out to be Hindu Yuva Sena leader K.T. Naveen Kumar, who was immediately arrested. All the evidence led to a right-wing Hinduita extremist organization, Sanatha Sanstha, who reject the Indian constitution and hope to establish a Hindu Rashtra by 2023.
Hindus are second-class citizens in their own country. Secularism is responsible for India's problems.
Pansare's alleged killer Samir Gaikwad, a member of the Sanatan Sanstha, is out on bail. While Kalburgi's alleged killer Rudra Patil, also a member of the same Sanstha, is on the run. Just days before Kalburgi's killing, a Bajrang Dal leader had tweeted, "Then it was you are Anantamurthy and now M.M. Kalburgi. Mock Hinduism and die a dog's death and dear K.S. Bhagwan, you are next." K.S. Bhagwan, a retired Mysore University professor, is currently under police protection. His name was also found in the Sanstha's Dr. Virendra Singh Tavade's home under a list stating hit list of anti-Hindu Rakshasas. Dabolkar and Kalburgi fought against blind beliefs and were instrumental in passing laws against quack claims. The Maharashtra Eradication of Black Magic Bill 2013 and the Karnataka Anti-Superstition Bill of 2017. Each of them fought against all irrational ideas, hence rationalists. They fought against the need for religion, religious rituals, prayers, astrology, casteism, all of which were diametrically opposed to the Sanstha's beliefs. Rationalism is as old as its opposite religion. Brihaspati, a philosopher who lived in 7th century BCE, is believed to be the founder of the Charvaka Lokyata Nastic school of philosophy.
We reject the Vedas as holy scriptures and all religious beliefs and God itself.
Freedom fighter Bhagat Singh had written an essay titled "Why I Am an Atheist," openly questioning the existence of any God whatsoever while he was in Lahore Central Jail in 1930. The DMK party itself is based on atheism, with K. Karunanidhi being an avowed atheist himself. He is the follower of E.V. Ramaswamy Naikar, also known as Periyar, who started the Dravidian movement, which is known to us as DMK in Tamil Nadu. Periyar openly criticized God and religion, and it is no wonder that religious goons defaced his statue recently in March 2018. Many books have been written in Europe, USA and England, like Why I'm Not a Christian by the British scholar Bertrand Russell, Why I'm Not a Hindu by Hyderabad-based political scientist and Dalit scholar Dr. Kancha Ilya Shepherd, Riddles of Hinduism by Dr. Balasaheb Ambedkar, in which he questioned Hindu religion itself, and Why I'm Not a Muslim by Dr. Ibn Warraq. Internationally, Steve Jobs, Bill Gates, Albert Einstein and many famous persons were all atheists.
Oh, they don't believe in God. They must be bad people.
But you will be surprised to learn that being an atheist does not stop them from doing good.
We are spending billions of our dollars and our time to eradicate disease in children and provide them with clean drinking water,
something God has surely forgotten to do. In a chilling similarity to what is happening in India, many of Bangladesh's atheists and free-thinking bloggers have been hacked to death in broad daylight in the streets of Dhaka. These attacks show that the Sanstha exists there as well. Only thing, they wear skull caps, keep beards and call themselves Muslims. Just like leaders in India, Bangladesh's PM Sheikh Hasina has also refused to take action against those responsible for the killings.
If they write something provocative and something bad happens, why should the government be responsible?
Looks like both countries want to stop all free thought and make themselves a version of Saudi Arabia. In a 2012 Win Gallup International poll conducted there,
how religious are you?
Don't you think close to 100% in Saudi Arabia would say, very religious? But no, Saudi Arabia has roughly the same proportion of non-religious and atheists as in the US. Eventually, the thoughts of these modern-day freedom fighters will prevail over the forces that try to silence us through fear. As the famous saying goes, the pen is mightier than the sword. Bizbo's Limerick! India's thought police has struck once again, threatening free thinkers with death or with pain. But the battle they are losing if they keep on abusing the freedom with which India has much to gain. All our videos are based on news and information published in leading international newspapers, magazines, professional journals and news channels, which we represent in a fun and interesting way. We pride ourselves on being a source of authentic news and information.